But I think at the end of the day, with everything, the diagnosis and everything, we just wanted to buy more time. You know, that was, if we could have more time with Matt, you know, like the way he is. And I that's really what I tried to simplify it down to. And I don't know if you, I mean, we said that to each other all the time. We said, if we could just have more time with him, whatever that was, if we could slow this down and just have more time with him, it was worth it.
And the actual clinical trial, they focused on ambulation. They focused on how many steps the kids could take. And they focused on language. I can't remember off the top of my head, but it was really speech and walking. So they weren't talking about eyesight. They weren't talking about, you know, slowing of seizures or any of that stuff. So we really, you know, from the pharmaceutical standpoint, we're just looking at trying to slow the progression of the disease so they can walk for a longer period of time and continued speech.
Yeah, and by no means did we, because this was the first treatment for it, by no means were we thinking, oh, this is going to have him have a regular life. We never had that expectation going into it. We were just trying to see if we could slow things down and buy more time. And then whatever else came along, we were going to deal with it, you know. And one of the big things, obviously, is the vision. His feet are turning in. So recently we had him have a procedure done where they lengthened the tendons in his feet so his feet could be flat again. So there are things that are coming that we have to deal with, you know, but first and foremost, he's still walking, he's still talking, so he can communicate with us, he gets his needs met. I think now with a drug to market, and I've talked to Michelle about this a lot, there needs to be, you know, parent advocacy, so to speak, of, okay, you know, you need to speak to someone who's actually been in the trial, or not been in the trial, but been through treatment, I should say, and can give you kind of an idea of what you're going to be dealing with. Because again, a lot of things now, you get your information, you look online, you get it like that. Oh, he's my son or daughter has CLN2. Oh, there's a treatment, Brineura. Oh, let's go get it and he or she will be fine. No, there's going to be things that pop up that, you know, you have to come to terms with. And, you know, and we got as much information as we could when we started it. But now with a lot of kids being on it, there's so much more information that could be shared that, you know, just a family calling, you know, a parent that's been through it to kind of say, okay, here's what happens. Here's what the port in getting put in is. And, here are some of the difficulties that you're going to kind of have to deal with as you go along here.